Hello there. In this video, I'm going to share you my experience how you can download your own templates in Bitrix and generate again and again your standard documents which you're currently using in your company. Okay, to generate documents, first of all, you shall go to deal, okay, and create some deals. In that particular case, I will create testing deal. Okay. And we'll select testing company, which I already created for especially for that video, and test contact name as well. Saving that, and I'm going to products, adding products as well. I'm sure that you know how to do that. For example, products name, products one, and give it price is 100, quantity 3. Add an arrow, products 2, and the price will be 300 and 4 pieces. Okay, when you save that, okay, going back to deal. Okay, for example, using that information like contract amount, invoice amount if you want, testing name of a company, and product details. For example, using that data, I want to generate some invoice. And that invoice should be looks exactly as this template. So I got address, I got invoice number, I got invoice date, I got bank details, I got to whom that invoice shall send to. And also I got some small table of products, okay? First of all, we will download that template inside of a Bitrix. For that, we shall go to Documents. So, in that particular video, I'm showing you how you can generate template of your documents using documents inside of a deal. Also, you can use invoice and even quotation code, but it's something different. I will show you it in our videos. So, go into Documents, add a new template, okay, upload. Select from your computer and just select that template. Okay, give a name like invoice for Europe. Invoice for Europe. Okay, signature stamp off, company, contact, lead. And all deals. Okay, now videos I will explain what the difference is. Okay, we'll be assigned to all employees and select invoice. Save. Okay, so we got to here. Now we're closing that. CTRL L, just update your page. Don't forget that bitrix24 is still the website. And go to document. And we got that invoice for Europe. Okay, so by the end we got the same document as we got here in that template. And what we shall do now, we shall extract somehow invoice number, invoice date, and to whom that invoice is dedicated to, and product descriptions. Okay, how we shall do that? We close on that document for now and go into document, add a new template, and now we go on this very small button. Very difficult to find, by the way. Go into fields. And here we shall to select which particular fields should be extracted from Bitrix database and published in this particular template. So first of all, we got invoice number. Okay, we shall type here number or invoice where and try to find here. Okay, we got document number, which is number here. Copy that. Going back to invoice, copy, and going back invoice date. Okay, let's try to find date. What kind of date we got? Okay, we got here, created on means document created inside of a deal, Okay, copy. Copy here. Okay, make it the same as before. Okay. Then going to here, to whom that invoice is dedicated to. Okay, in that case, you get two options. Okay, we shall go to back to the... Okay, first of all, we shall extract a test company address. Okay, should be address, city, country. Okay, for that case, you shall go to the company and select fields which is assigned for the address of that company. For example, click change here inside of the company, go into the company details. Okay, details, company. Okay, and you may put like testing company name here and select strict address and put it here. There is one option, okay? But also you can add special fields or select special fields like here and select from other sections and address and office or add the new special parameters and then extract them to your particular document, okay? Same with that. So in this particular case, the name of company name will be here as company requisite name, which is here. Okay, I'll show you again. Okay, this is name is company requisite name. Okay, type in like that. We're going back to fields. Okay, some company, and choosing from the company. Okay, company name, company title. In that particular case, it could be company requisite name. So we copy that. Going back. Okay, copy paste street address. Okay, we shall type here address. Okay, company. Primary address 1. Okay, here. Copy that. City. Okay, where is the city? Okay, we got company requisite, primary address, city. We shall copy that. Past. Okay, and country. Okay, no, it's not contact, it's company requisite. No, not that. We have primary address, which is country. Company requisite, primary country. Okay, we shall copy that. Okay, then format that. Okay, save that. Okay, let's put that template back to Bitrix. Okay, we're going to edit this template, upload, select, test box. Uploading that. Save that. Okay, then I'm closing CTRL R, or SMDR, document, invoice for Europe. Okay, create new. Okay, I got a document, let's check that. We got invoice number, we got date, we got testing company, but we don't have a street address, we have city, we have country. Which it put it. Okay, let's check what we've done wrong with street address. Okay, going back. Okay, press. Okay, what kind of options we got for now? We got contacts, should select company, requisite, primary, address 1. So, requisite means from extracting from requisite of a company. Okay, copy. Okay, now it's the same. We've done it wrong. We have put it last time contact. Okay, just deleting that. Format. Okay, let's try again. Okay. I can edit from here, edit template, download. Save. Okay, closing that document, SMD error. Document, invoice favorable, create new one. Okay, let's check that. Okay, we doesn't change that, and we got proposed trade, St. Petersburg, US, testing company. So we got everything in place. Okay, now we shall extract properly product name, rates, house, units, amounts, etc. Okay, I'm going back and type here products. Okay, so we got, first of all, we need to put number of the products, which is telling by your secret colon in Bitrix as index. Okay, just type index. Okay, products index, copy and paste. Then description means product name in that case. We are okay. Maybe it would be better if we type product. So we got product's name here. Copy, paste, just in the middle. Okay, rate. And then in our case, is the price. Okay, product price. Copy, hours, in our case it's that product's quantity, okay, and unit measurement name, might be somewhere here. Okay, it's product's measure name, we copying that here, and amount. So it means that amount for product price multiplied by quantity. Okay, it should be price. So we shall copy product price sum. And we shall find the total. Total sum of the invoice. So total amount, total sum, copy, paste, format document, save. Okay, let's download that document back to Bitrix. Edit template as usual. Download. Save. Update your page. And generate document again. By then we got a document. Let's check products. So we got index, product's name, rate, or which is a price of each product. Quantity, units, so total amount for each product, and total amount for all products. So I should say that that document is accepted for us. We can send that via email or download as a PDF and send to our customers. This video was useful for you, and if you think that I didn't cover something which is important for you, please put your comments under that video, and I will have some ideas what kind of topics you're interested in to show you next time. Thank you very much. Please subscribe for my channel, put likes, and good luck.